excited to be here. As you can see, I'm a girl. I am proud to be a Nigerian and also an African. This is my community. It is called Makoko, and I live somewhere around here. I love it. But guess what? I didn't choose all these things. We do not choose where we are born into. We do not choose our nationality, ethnicity, or gender. We do not choose who our parents will be. Neither do we choose who our siblings are. But one thing we can choose is the kind of life we live, the impact we can make, and the legacies we would leave or lay. Since I was 5, I've always been asked one question. I guess most of you have also been asked the same question when you were younger. The question is, what will you be when you grow up? My teachers would call me future pilot, future journalist. My uncles would ask, Maryam, you are getting old. What do you want to be when you grow up? And even my parents, especially my mom, who is not so educated, but is eager to know what I want to be when I grow up. But people really care to know what I can do now or what impact I can create now. They just feel we are leaders of tomorrow, but they often forget that we can be leaders of today also. As children, people feel we are too young to create a great impact. They feel we are blind and cannot see what is going on around us. They feel we are too naive to have certain conversations. They feel we are too little to learn certain things. But they forget that if they don't teach us, we will still learn, probably from the wrong people, and sooner than they could even imagine. As a child, I believe that every child deserves better. I believe that our voices need to be heard. I believe that we need to be part of certain conversations and policy formulations, especially ones that are meant for us. There is this Yoruba adage that says, Agbalagbo Kinkuro. In English, it means an adult does not tell lies. But I know of many adults that tell lies. Literally, it means, as a child, if you know an adult that tell lies, you cannot or should not correct them. This is not fair. I hardly go to programs and see children speak on the same stage as adults. This is a rare opportunity for me, and I think you should give yourselves a round of applause.
Who says children are dull, unintelligent, naive, and are too young to create impact in their community? I believe every child is a treasure and has the innate potential to transform their communities. Every child is like a candle in a dark room, and all they need are people who wouldn't just see the candle, but also the potential of that candle to light up that room. Let me show you a few of our friends, young people like us, creating great impact in their community. Here is Zuria Oduwole, one of the youngest, yet the strongest voices advocating for female education in Africa. At the age of 10, she was profiled by Forbes magazine, and at 12, she became the world's youngest filmmaker. A movie went on to show in England, Japan, South Africa. Today, at the age of 17, Zuria has interviewed over 30 world leaders. And today, she was listed among the 100 most influential people by the New African Journal. She was a child, creating an impact in her community. This is another of our friends. His name is Toby. Growing up as a child, he was suffering from dyslexia, a disability that impairs reading, spelling, and even writing. Growing up in a remote community in Ogbomosho, his teachers, who were supposed to teach him, inspire him, and even believe in him, thought he was under a spell just because he couldn't read early. Though, few people still believed in him, just like his mom, who passed on a few years ago. Fortunately, Toby turned out to become one of the youngest inventors in Nigeria. His first invention at the age of 12 was a lawnmower that makes use of solar. He went on to design and build a solar grinding machine, as well as a foot mat alarm that alerts its owner when visitors step on it without having them to ring a bell. Toby was also a child trying to create an impact in his community. We have our friends, Celestine and Monday. They are from Makoko community. They make use of scrap materials and waste products to build solar-powered cars and trains and battery-powered automobiles. They were also children trying to create an impact in their community. These are four amazing Nigerian schoolgirls: Adebola, Eniola, Oluwatoyin, and Abiola. We realize that the problem of power outage in their community is becoming something unbearable to them. So they created a urine power generator that turns a liter of urine into nearly 6 hours of electricity. They've won several awards and recognition. They were also children trying to create an impact in their community. I'm sure we've all heard about William Kakwamba, the little boy from Malawi, who gained fame across the world and also saved this community from famine. It was by building a windmill that powered up most of his electrical appliances in his house and also provided water for his community using waste products and scrap materials. It was celebrated globally, and recently, his story has inspired millions through a movie called The Boy Who Harnessed the Wind. William was also a child, and being a child did not limit him. Last year, myself, Maryam, and a few other Slum to School beneficiaries, after our summer innovation camp, realized that there are many children who were not in school in our community. So we went into our community. We take down the names of children who were not in school. And through the support of Slum to School volunteers, we were able to make a video to create awareness and also raise funds for these children. Successfully, we were able to enroll 510 children into school. We were also children trying to create an impact in our community. Over the years, one of the things I've learned is that true success is not a measure of how much money you have, the number of certificates you own, or the number of exams you passed. But true success is the measure of the impact you create, the lives you've touched, and the legacy you are going to leave behind.
Fortunately, the stories Emmanuel just shared are our true stories, stories of our friends. But unfortunately, that's not the full picture. I also want to share the stories of our friends that represent millions of out-of-school children in Nigeria and Africa. They are our brothers who at the age of 4, 5, 6, and even up to 10, are forced to go out on the streets to beg for their daily bread because of culture or religion. They are called the Almajiris. These children deserve better. I also want to share the stories of our sisters who at the age of 9, 10, 11, 12 are forced to get married to older men because their parents are poor and need someone to train them, or because their culture is still backward. These children deserve better. I wouldn't forget the young boys and girls that are brought from several villages to the city to serve as house boys and house girls. They are literally house slaves, because the biological children in these homes are older than they are, but these children are forced to do the chores that those biological children can do. These children also deserve better. Every morning, as I go to school, I come across several children in my community who have never, and may never go to school. They are the boys who go to the sea with their fathers to fish, and the girls who go with their mothers to sell in the markets, and those that walk on the streets. You may have driven past them while coming, and you may still drive past them while going. These children also deserve better. Even some of these children are at home, idle, not doing anything, and they represent the statistics of over 30 million out-of-school children in Nigeria alone. These children also deserve better. Even some of my friends who attend public schools and go to school every single day don't access quality education. Some of their classrooms are dilapidated. Some of their curriculums are outdated. And some of their teachers are not competent and they are not experienced. These children also deserve better. In fact, every child, like myself and Emmanuel, deserve a Nigeria that works for all of us. We deserve a Nigeria where every child can dream and watch that dream come true. We deserve a Nigeria where our rights are nurtured, our rights are protected, promoted, and supported. We deserve a Nigeria where our schools nurture our talents, not force expectations and certain professions on us. We deserve teachers that don't just teach us about history, but will inspire us to make history. We deserve teachers that don't teach us about the science and inventions of the Philip Emeagwalis, the Albert Einsteins, and the Isaac Newtons, but will inspire us to invent so that future generations can learn about our inventions. We deserve teachers that don't just be interested in the names of noisemakers and punish us for talking, but the teachers that will teach us to use our words and voices to speak up for those whose voices can't be heard. We want an educational system that will not just teach us how to pass examinations, but will prepare us to build up the Nigeria of our dreams.
So when next you see a child, or even when you get home to meet your children, don't just ask them what they would like to be when they grow up, but ask them what impact they are creating today. And whenever they speak, don't just shut them up when they speak. Be patient to listen to whatever they have to say. Inspire them to be innovators and inventors. Encourage them to exploit their artistic creativity and encourage them to transform their community in little ways so that together, we can build the Nigeria of our dream. Thank you.